हेलो, टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू डिस्कस हाइबरनेट। यू ऑलरेडी नो व्हाट इज मीन बाय JDBC, जावा डेटाबेस कनेक्टिविटी, व्हिच इज एन API यूज टू एक्सेस डेटाबेस इन अ जावा प्रोग्राम। इट इज अ टूल फॉर जावा डेटाबेस कनेक्शन एंड वेरियस मेथड्स एंड क्यूरीज प्रोवाइडेड बाय JDBC फॉर एक्सेसिंग डेटाबेसेस एंड फॉर मेकिंग कनेक्शन। ड्राइवर्स आर प्रोवाइडेड बाय JDBC। फोर टाइप्स ऑफ ड्राइवर्स, टाइप वन, टाइप टू, टाइप थ्री, टाइप फोर। बट इन हाइबरनेट, हाइबरनेट इज एन ऑब्जेक्ट रिलेशनल मैपिंग टूल विच इज यूज टू मैप डेटाबेस टेबल्स टू जावा क्लासेस। मीन्स स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ टेबल एंड स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ क्लास इज सेम बिकॉज यू वॉन्ट टू मैप क्लास टू जावा क्लास टू टेबल। इट इज ईजी टू इम्प्लीमेंट एंड यूजिंग ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग कंसेप्ट ऑफ जावा टू डेटाबेस टेबल्स। Hibernate makes the connection itself, and in Hibernate to operate over the tables we use Hibernate's query language. In JDBC we use structured query language SQL. Here we use Hibernate's query HQL, Hibernate's query language. See the client, then Hibernate session factory. It is a first we have to see Hibernate framework acts as an intermediate layer between Java objects and relational database. Advantages: Hibernate framework is an open source framework. It is a high performance framework because of its internal cache. It maps Java classes to database tables using XML files, and if any change is made to the database, then we have to change these XML files only, no need to change in logic. We have to change the database tables from XML files. All the settings are required in XML files for mapping. It provides a database independent query language HQL, Hibernate query language. It provides a facility to create tables from your Java application. We can create table from our Java application. No application server is required to execute the Hibernate. This is the architecture of Hibernate. Java application, persistent object, Hibernate mapping file, configuration file. Two files are there, mapping file and configuration file. Core components of Hibernate architecture: Java application, persistent object, configuration, session factory, session, transaction, query and criteria. These are JNDI, JDBC, JTA. These are the internal layers and then relational database. Configuration object consists the configuration file used by the Hibernate. That is hibernate.cfg means configuration.xml. This is the configuration file which consists the configuration file used by the configuration object consists the configuration file used by the Hibernate. It contains information about database connection and class mapping. And another file is there, that is hbm.xml. That is called class mapping file. Configuration object is used to create the object of session factory. It depends on one another: configuration, session factory to session, session to transaction, transaction to query, and query to criteria. Session factory object is created from the configuration object. It is thread shape object and used by all threads of the application. It acts as a factory for session objects and client for connection provider. because all the database connection information is stored into hibernate.cfd.xml. It maintains the second level cache of the data. Then third, session object. The session object is created from the session factory object. It acts as a factory for transaction, query and criteria. Session objects are not thread safe. It maintains the first level cache. Then, next, transaction object, which is created from the session object. A transaction object represents an atomic unit of work. Then query object is created from session object. It uses SQL and HQL to perform database operations. And the criteria object is created from the session object. It is used to define and execute the object-oriented criteria queries. These are the main components of, core components of Hibernate. Then, see the example, see the difference between JDBC and Hibernate. JDBC doesn't support lazy loading. Hibernate does support lazy loading, which offers better performance. JDBC is responsible for creating and closing the connections. If you open the connection, then close. You have to close the connection in JDBC. But in case of Hibernate, runtime system takes care of creating and closing the connections. No worries for connections. JDBC is a technology, Hibernate is a object relational mapping framework. It doesn't support associations. These are some of the basic differences between JDBC and Hibernate. See the example. First, we have to create a class, persistent class for, suppose, student. Student database is available. The structure of database is student ID, first name, last name, class name, roll number, age. Public class, student. This is a bin class. It contains no argument constructor and setter and getter methods for every variable from ID to age. Six methods are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 means 12 methods are there, set and get. Then mapping file contains, suppose this is the Hibernate database for Oracle database we want to connect. Then this contains session factory, Hibernate configuration, session factory. Here we have to provide the driver name for Oracle driver, username, password, then driver name, here localhost, path, property name, all the information we have to provide for the database connection. Then student.hpm.xml, which contains mapping information. Here ID, student ID, type, int, column, student ID. Then first name, last name, class name, roll number, age, all the columns of the table. That is a mapping from which class and from column to column name and field name. Then Hibernate util.java. This is the class getting the Hibernate session object. Here, see the public class Hibernate util. Then session factory, we have to create the object for session factory. Core components of Hibernate. First, you have to create a session, then session factory. Build session factory, then configuration, create the object for configuration, configure hibernate.cfg.xml. This is the database connection information. Get the session factory object from configuration. Session factory is equal to configuration dot build session factory. Then return session factory. It is a connection from class to database. Then Hibernate test.java, this class is used for Hibernate operations. Actually class Hibernate test, first you have to create the object student, new student, then setting the object properties, first name, last name, class name, roll number, age, these are the object properties. Get the session object, Hibernate util dot get session factory dot open session, Hibernate util this is the class, we have to take the session object and this we have to import this class for the session object. Student dot set first name, student dot set last name, we have to setting the object properties, then sessions start with Hibernate util get session factory object here, then tx is equal to session dot begin transaction, session dot save, insert a new student record in the database, we have to give the values and then we can insert using session dot save, you can directly insert in the database student, and if no errors then we have to commit the session tx.commit. If error occurs it can handle the errors. If everything is successful then it will display the message save successfully. This is the basic idea behind the Hibernate. When you want to change the driver or database, you can directly change the XML file. And it is easy and fast than JDBC. If you can change here in XML, then no need to worry about the, no need to change the code of the program. Because of this XML settings, all the logic is implemented. This is the basic about Hibernate. Here, see another example. I have to create one application, new project, web application 27. In NetBeans, how to do that? First, you have to download Hibernate final dist folder, latest Hibernate version. And from lib folder, see the jar files which are required for the Hibernate and add library. You can add the jar files here for the Hibernate. Then this is the web application in using and. See, first you have to see hibernate.cfg.xml. Here entities is the database and subscriber is the table. Therefore subscriber hbm.xml is mapping. Subscriber contains entities.subscriber and table is equal to subscriber. Property name, first field is a properties password field and ID, that is a username. First field is the ID and then property PWD. This is the mapping information about table, first you have to see subscriber.java. I have to create one package, entities, and here public class subscriber implement serializable. Two variables are there because of services. Therefore, I want to open XAMPP for database connection. Start. We can start Apache Server and MySQL. Then see the services, databases, database connection start. Connect using, give the password. My password is root and password. Then next, finish. Connection already exists. Here already connection is there. Connect MySQL. Test is my database and subscriber table, which contains username and password. Username and password, two fields are there. Therefore, we have to create our class and create two fields, uname, pwd, and by insert code, you have to create here get and set properties. Add property, set and get properties. Then in project register, create one servlet which have method register servlet.java. I have bookmark one site which contains Srikanth. History, open this history. Okay, See the example here. Already subscriber Java is there, and then we have to create the register servlet which contains business logic, and that servlet we have to call into here. Form action. It is change. Type submit and value register. You can call that servlet here. This is the basic idea how to do Hibernate application into NetBeans. And what is the internal settings are required for the Hibernate application? Already I have told you, that is, first you have to download the Hibernate latest version, then add libraries, and then start your Apache Tomcat server, and then you have to create one class as per the your database table structure, and then database name and table name in the hibernate.cfg.xml file, then create one servlet and register.html file, which is the interface for the for your database table fields. You have to design the interface for input values, and then create here form action is equal to register and method is equal to post, and this is the interface which is required for your table values. Then register is the servlet pattern. Here register servlet dot java is a servlet and register is a URL pattern. Therefore here we have to use register. Then register servlet extend HTTP servlet. It is the default. All the classes are there in servlet. Here we have to use string uname and password, get parameter for two values, and then session factory sf new annotation configuration. Here you have to use session factory, then session object, and then create all the objects and access that object, session object, and begin transaction. Yes.save and sub is the subscriber object. Subscriber is a table, table structure. Here subscriber public class, subscriber which contains this. Therefore you have to use subscriber dot create object of subscriber, then yes dot save, yes dot get transaction dot commit, yes dot close, session factory dot close, then has been registered successfully. It will give the message. This is the basic idea about Hibernate. What is the difference between Hibernate and JDBC, and why it is better than JDBC? Because of XML settings, we can change everything in Hibernate. Thank you.